7. Come and learn to dance.
Bully, bully.
Bully, bully. Bully, bully. Bully, bully. Bully, bully. Watch it now, watch it, watch it, watch it.
And now we're here on the spot. This is the area we're going to build a trap, and I think the crew will probably have a mutiny when they see how steep and rugged it is right here. Comes another load of supplies. Here's some sheep just walking on the ridge above the trap we're going to build.
I would like to take him home. He gave me some.
Brian and Jerry, Rick, Kenny. Here we are building the trap down in the bottom of the canyon. There's our destination, out over those white bluffs. There's Jerry coming down the ridge. Brian should be above him. Somewhere up on the rocks is Rick and the other guys. Brian's up in there somewhere. I see him. There's a sheep headed up the ridge. We got a bunch of sheep going up this canyon. I want to zoom it in, see if we can pick them up. There's Brian.
I can hear him, but I can't see him.
Go ahead and cross. We got about 100 head coming right up this ridge down here to my left. You guys need to be across those canyons. Keep them rimming.
Tyler and Sam are up on top there somewhere. Right on the skyline. I can't see them. There's two sheep going up that white bluff on the other side. I'll see if I can bring them into where you can see them.
Sam, do you have a copy?
Yeah, copy. Go ahead.
Yeah, do you see these 10 sheep going up this first white ridge?
Okay.
Yeah, do you see them, Sam?
Let me take a look.
Here's our sheep rimming out around the top.
Okay, Rick. Off to your left, between above that little green tree to your left, right up on that little nose, a couple of sheep, you and a lamb at least, watching you. I don't know how many more there might be.
We lost them all there at the gate. Lost about 40, about 100 went through. Here's more sheep scattered around on these bluffs. There's Kenny coming up the bottom. He beat him to the bottom. This is the climb we got. Enormous slide that went out here last year. It went out so big a slide that it actually created its own little peninsula out there. Goldie.
kind of sick. We can get her.
Okay. We'll do. Sorry.
Oh, no, I'm good at that.
Good job.
Thank you for telling me. All I have to do is follow directions. That's the hard point.
Let's do it.
If you cut across like that,
part of another gather coming through North No Man's Land, getting the sheep started here. We pick up, there's Martine down on that point. Larry and Mike are way over there in those trees coming down that ridge over there. Kind of panoramic view of the country that we're in today. There's a few sheep holed up on a point there that we've driven out of the canyon. Standing there. Pretty rugged country we're in here. Daryl's up above us in the rocks. Brian's on top there. I don't think you can see him yet. See if we can find some sheep here. Should be some moving out. There's some holed up in a draw. I'm gonna move out now. We've got approximately 30 sheep in front of us somewhere in these rocks. There's a bunch below us here we're trying to kick out.
Maybe go to your right about 50 yards, Martine, and then roll a big rock off down there. Maybe you'll be able to turn them, and then you can go up back around the ridge the other way.
We got them moving now. Hoot! Got some headed out. This drive, it's hard to tell how many are in front of you. Have a little view of the landscape here. It's probably a little rougher than this camera shows. Daryl and Brian are working up there trying to get a bunch turned back. Some more going out. We'll go through that pass right there. Here comes Martine up the trail. Tired. Going everywhere but in the gate that we want them to. Missed the gate again. They're going, finally, all but two. Captured. And the sheep are in, and here's our sunset. Beautiful.
San Mateo Point to Mexico follows. Tonight.
The lunch getting away. Fred's trying to turn them. Nola. They're going up an unbelievably steep bluff. We have some sheep down on this point that we ran out there last night. We put a tarp across some dead end point to see if they could, it would hold them there, and so far it has. I don't know if we can, there's the tarp. The sheep are down on that point right out there. We'll try to go around the back side over on that ridge there. One guy will go down and make enough noise and possibly they'll come out and we can take them to a trap. We've come around to the other side, and as soon as the sailboat's out of here, we're going to start them out. Let's take them all the way up that hard back ridge. Into the sun here in a minute. Have to go up that ridge through there and out over the top right there. It should be Fred and some guys sitting right there with a tarp right there. Got a tarp laid out so they try to cross back on this side to head them straight. John and Sam are up that end to turn them. And we're going to get going here as soon as the boat leaves.
Probably up to you, Ralph, whenever you want to start those fireworks now that that little boat's out of there.
There's the sheep. And right underneath there actually is an arch that goes clear through the rock and comes out the other side. There they go. Got them lined out. They're moving out finally. There they go, right up the crown. They're headed out. Cutting across the saddle. Okay, guys, I'm headed out. This is Goldie on the four-wheeler. Goldie. I haven't seen him before. He's a new one. He might have come in from somewhere else. There's Forehead here. Here's a shot of the country that we're driving to. The Five-Head that I was just after got back on me. Kind of give you an idea of what we got here. There's where we need to eventually wind up. Right on those trees on the skyline. And then there's a fence that goes down into our trap right there. Here's a little view of the country. A few sheep scattered out in front of us moving along. Sam's on that ridge right there somewhere. Probably underneath the crown there. John should be coming up through those ridges right in there. I haven't picked him out yet, but he's down there. He'll be coming up through that open country. Sam will be coming right about this, the middle of the camera's level right there. And I'm going to be coming through just under the crown through these rims here. Yeah, we've got some going finally. Moving on around. 10 head or so. Kind of waiting here for the guys on the four-wheelers to get into position. At the end of this drive, they wait down a ridge and they come up in behind them and we spread out a big tarp. Kind of haze them over the hill. Goldie! Got one held up right in there. I guess he crawled in the rocks. There he is. There's Brian gonna try to snare him. He went back.
Hoi! Hoi! Hoi!
There we are, we got him. Roped him right here. Daryl got one. I roped that ewe and Brian roped the ram. Got him. Got one on Daryl's bike. Tying him on. Crossed one drainage and now they're headed out the other side. Here we are working our way toward the beach. There's about 14 big rams in there. All big rams. Got them headed out. Got about probably 3 miles to go to the trap. Well, here's the crew finally at the trap.
Now, do you guys need to get your gear off?
This is a beach at prisoners. There's our landing craft coming into prisoners. Pick up a load of sheep.
try it. You got to really time the swell when the boat's going up and down like this. You know, it'll be an 8 or 10 inch difference in height. Like right now, he's got to just haul ass. Not now, though. See, now the boat's going back up. When the boat goes down, then do it.
The country where we're making a run this morning, and the sheep in the background are just starting to drive. Tyler and Kenny, Brian, Sam. Jerry's way up there. Rick's in that area somewhere.
Rick? Jack, can you see me?
And Daryl's down that canyon.
A while ago, but I don't see you. Now. Hey, Rick, there's a group of sheep.
This is the country we've got to drive them to. There's the trap up there. There they're coming back. You got them turned. Beat our best day.
Oh, by far. I bet we got 200 heads today. 66 this morning, we got 150 of them. Damn close to it. So.
This is part of today's catch. This is the best run we've had, the luckiest and the best. We'll make sure the boat's coming. There's the last of them, hopefully going through the gate. There they go. A landing craft coming in. Ready to ship a load of sheep out. Scorpion, main headquarters here.
excited already.
Five, we need 11, so there they are right there. Yeah.
Lights up tight of giving me the creeps, just a Winnemucca trucker with a load of black sheep. Just a winking and a blinking with a stinking load of sheep.
She's up here. Both black ones are right here. She's in the second bunch leading it. Kind of hard to film this. We're in the middle of a run. There's Rebecca standing by the Bowman gate. That
which is on cables, and it just slides across when they come by and come through there. Here's the trap we're going to run them into. These sheep are all in the trap, that we little wing trap that we've got as a backup to the main trap. We had to cut them off, and so now we have to tie all these down and haul them out. We're about to start to rope all the sheep here, tie them down. There's Rebecca with her, all of her tie strings. What we got to try to do is rope the ones that we have most apt to jump first. Got about 48 of them tied up so far here. Now we got to catch all the little ones. This is the way we haul them out, put the babies in the basket, tie the big ones behind. I know it. That hopefully it couldn't be any better. Them other bottom ones, they had to be the old ones. This is going down to the bottom of the canyon below Teardrop, and sheep are headed up what's called Ass Kicker Hill. Because once you start up it, you almost have to run all the way at the top to keep the sheep going into the trap.
56 head between the two bunches.
Sounds good. Hold still, horse. What do you think? Have Brian go up the ridge and we cut across the bottom. Here's what we got today. Bunch of big rams. Here comes one more.
like somebody took a paintbrush and painted it, doesn't it?
Man, that's beautiful this morning.
It's Charlie Russell sky there.
Sun coming up on some of the cliffs and the canyons that we're going to work today. Some more footage of the hills we're going into today. We're walking up now. We have our four-wheelers parked out yesterday at noon. So we get part way up, we can pick them up them to keep up with the sheep. But there's a beautiful bright red bush this morning. Sun hitting it. Panoramic view of the country. There's a hawk sitting there. There's the first sheep in the drive that we've spotted. They're about a half a mile in front of us. Feeding on a ridge.
Yeah, it looks like 10 or so up there on that ridge of yours, Ralph, up on that top of that hill.
There's Brian a little further up his ridge. Some of the canyons these sheep live in. There's caves on the side of these canyons, and the sheep get in there when it's hot. Kind of hard to get out sometimes.
Yeah, there's 8 or 10 sheep going right straight up your ridge over there, Ralph. Just perfect. Right up the ridge line.
Okay.
They're on the move. Everything's on the move pretty good now, so.
Here's some that are held up on us in this canyon. Eventually, we got to wind up on the skyline there. That's where the trap is. We've got sheep going out through there in different places. Not going to be able to tape very much. We got sheep going everywhere. Sheep there, sheep there, going up the ridges, and a bunch of them, Larry, just turned way up on top. A bunch of them being chased over there.
There's some more coming up out of the bottom, Larry. Right where those came up, right there. Those are going right for them. Maybe they'll hit them down.
Here's the last of the sheep going into the trap. We've lost a whole bunch of them, but we got this last bunch. I'm not sure exactly how many we got. Probably 40 or 50. Hopefully Larry can get in behind these and turn them. I got one more turn to go. Ah, they're headed the right way. Good job, Larry. They're headed for the gate. Let's make, hopefully they go in. If we see sheep in the video right there, we made it. Hey, look at that. Another 8 or 9 head. End of another drive, except for taking them to the bigger, the littler trap. Lane runs about a little over a quarter of a mile, maybe a third of a mile, all the way down to the shipping pen. They're coming off of there now. Back it up here, you can get the whole thing in perspective. Oh, they're going back on them, they'll turn them. Fairly successful, we had about 40 head probably get back on us over ridges. And some of them we had to let go to keep the main bunch. We'll see how many we got when we get down to the bottom here. I'm gonna have to back up so I don't blow it for them. There's the trap, we're almost there. Should be helping them, but I'm gonna video it.
Oh,
I gotta go. Oh, it's closing the gate or something.
Right there.
Three little ones got out. That's all we got left to get from this bunch. Here's what we're going after, the rat pack. Here's the rat pack after three little ones that got out. This is always interesting. This one was an easy one. They got them, all right.
That ain't a good sign.
Is he looking at you there, Brian? Yeah, getting the trap ready for the next run. Get these last bunch of rams out of here. Pick up down in its hole. Quite the loading position we have here. All loaded and starting out. Another load of sheep head for the boat.
Alright, bastard. What do we got? 14?
Still.
Wait just a second, Brian. Let me see if I can get these. Hey!
I'm trying to get them going up.
Hey!
Cheap jump. Whee! Hey!
Hey, follow up in there. Hey! Hey, take her.
This is the way they're supposed to go in. We are unloading at our final destination.
out, dude. If you guys go any further, you're gonna push them out over to the west.
Tom's down there with one goldie caught.
Okay, so we'll go back up and then head over to the west, okay?
And there's Dwayne again. What we're gonna try to do is pack them over to a ledge here and have the chopper take them out. They came out of there, and now they're pulling this little ram right up the ridge. Brian's pretty unhappy about it, but he's doing okay.
I need a raise. There you go, Sam.
We all need a raise. Rebecca's giving words of encouragement to this whole project. Very inspirational. Now we're talking to Charlie in the helicopter to see if we can coordinate sheep removal from this steep terrain. It's hand, claw over fist up this steep shaley ridge.
So he's one,
yep.
Two, three.
You alright, Ralph?
Yeah?
How'd the shoulder do on that rock? One, two, three.
For anybody's information, that was Ralph Lawston that just about went back down to the bottom of the canyon, but he made a great recovery and is carrying on like you wouldn't believe. There they are. They're not quite up, but they're getting close to the ridge top.
They're right, yo.
Loli went right down there to him. She kept sniffing. I knew the son of a guns were there because she kept sniffing and sniffing.
Well, it could have been down there on the line, but other than that,
oh, no! No! Oh!
to really.
Okay, well, who do you
think? I did on that one, trying to go a different route. I was like,
got
off. Oops. Didn't quite flip it.
This one's got the,
yeah,
got the you can see what happens when you do that.
Yeah, I wasn't.
Goldie, we needed you off.
My eyes were all.
Yeah, it couldn't have been.
Okay, I'll pull up here and you guys just. Help. Come on, come on. Well, there, Ralph's crawling up there with the dog on the right. We've got a sheep here in this little slide area off the steep cliffs that's been here for about 4 months. Probably swam around the end of the island when we roped another ewe a little while ago. It's been here ever since, grazing on the vegetation and getting moisture that it needs from the vegetation that it's eating primarily, because there's no water in here. It's survived very well. It's starting to perk up now as Goldie and Ralph get closer and closer. There it goes, it's running. We got a crew of people up here on this little slide area. Missed the first go, so we'll try it again. Comes Goldie.
That sheep's gonna get some water.
That sheep might just jump into the water again. It's been a swimmer before this. This is the sheep crew strategy at its very best. Look at that, right down on the water's edge. Right there in the water. David's getting close. He's gonna grab on. It's getting awful close. Did we get a grab? It looks like.
You want us to come in? Yeah, wait for some help first.
Yeah, help first. They'll tie its legs up with a pig and string, and we've got Ralph and Goldie and David and Dwayne and Brian and Kenny in on shore.
Hey, you guys, 1, 2, 3, beer.
Oh, ready?
I'll try to get it over there, TJ.
Can you come in this side too?
Okay.
We're going to have to leave a couple of the sheep crew so we can get over to the beach with this sheep and drop it off and get it up to the corrals.
Drop it on the beach?
Yeah, just take it off over there.
call, Brian. Two.
Yeah, four.
There's another one up there running around. I don't see anything down there.
Downhill and grabbed on, it broke right off, and right on downhill I went.
You weird.
Ready?
Yeah. Got one, he'd run right through that little wooden gate.
Where'd he land at? Right where he put that up?
Okay, don't fall down.
Come here. That cold. Come here, cold. Well,
look, I just looked in the summertime.
What Brian told me.
Really?
Be on your ass in that dry grass and rocks.
Okay, Sam.
Here, Goldie. Hey,
Goldie, come here. I will. I'm not right now, but I will.
Goldie!
Here we are, back on the island again, looking for one sheep. This is a view of North No Man's Land.
and I'll take his place. I definitely need somebody else down here where I'm at so I can move around here and make sure he doesn't rim around to my left, and then somebody needs to watch so he doesn't come up this canyon here.
Run it all the way out here, there's none left. You're using your reserves.
That's what I do. I've never got a way to work.
You like to see.
That sure looks a lot better. Don't you feel a little bit sorry for that maggot, Larry?
Is he making it? No, he's
he don't feel sorry for us.
Thank you.
there's this place we're gonna ride, up where the rim rock meets the night. We'll go hand in hand, riding through the purple starlight, and the coyote on the wind sends his lonely lover's call. We'll hold each other close in the wonder of it all. The golden west has come and gone right before our very eyes, but they will never count the stars, and they will never fence the skies. All I know is I love you, and I won't let you fall. We're rolling down the Milky Way into the wonder of it all.